In this example, we are given that a clamped at middle or metal rod of length 1 meter and density 7.5 gram per centimeter cube gives dust heaps in a cone tube at an interval of 8 centimeter. We are required to calculate the Young's modulus of the material of rod, and it is given that the speed of sound and gas used in the cone tube is 400 meters per second. So here we can directly state, as the rod is clamped at middle, we can write wavelength of waves in the rod can be written as 2 meter, because the length of rod is taken as lambda by 2. So wavelength of waves in rod can be written as 2 meter because the rod is of length 1 meter. And it is given that dust heaps are at an interval of 8 centimeter. So we can say wavelength of sound in the gas is 16 centimeter, because the loop length is given as 8 centimeter, lambda of gas by 2 is 8 centimeter. And we know in Kunst tube, frequency of oscillation in rod is equal to frequency of oscillation in gas. So we can write speed in gas by wavelength in gas is equals to speed in rod by wavelength in rod. This will give us velocity of sound in rod to be equals to V gas multiplied by lambda rod by lambda gas. If we substitute the values, this 400 multiplied by 2 divided by 0.16. On simplifying, we'll get the speed to be 5000 meters per second. And as we know, velocity in a metal rod can be given as root of Young modulus by density. This implies Young modulus can be written as rho v rod square, which is equal to 7.5 into 10 to power 3. I've just changed the units to kilogram per meter cube multiplied by 5000 square. On simplifying, the result I'm getting is 1.875 into 10 to power 11 newton per meter square. That is the Young modulus for this metal rod. That is the answer to this problem.